Good morning.
And welcome to Live with Lucky.
Happy Thursday, October 14th. Good morning, Miss Restrepo. Happy Thursday.
Happy Thursday.
So good to have you on the show. I can't wait to see why you're here today.
Who knows?
It's going to be great. Well, let's get started. That will come later. I need all my scholars in the house on this Thursday, Thinking Maps Thursday, to be exact, to stand up. Everybody stand up. Get your wiggles out. Salute and pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Shumpo. And now for our Shamrock Pledge, stay standing and say it with me. Don't make me say it by myself, scholars. We are the scholars of Shamrock Gardens. We are dedicated, committed, and focused. We prepare for greatness by doing our best every day. We cooperate with our classmates, teachers, and staff. We respect ourselves and all people. We know that hard work is the key to success. There are no limits to how far we can go. We dream big, believe, and achieve. We will graduate from high school and be college and career ready. We will succeed. We will succeed. Thanks. Oh, well, let's check out what we have for lunch today, scholars. Lunchtime. It's a pizza day. You can have either cheese pizza, pepperoni pizza. So we got cheese or pepperoni. You can have your usual options of yogurt, hummus, wow butter sandwich, or a veggie pinwheel. Your very important veggies today are roasted cauliflower or sweet potato waffle fries. Delicious veggie choices. You have a variety of fruits today, including an apple, diced pears, strawberry craisins, apple crisps, raisins, and the tropical floret raisette. And as always, a variety of milks. I have loved seeing this start with Hello Week. Thanks for everyone who participated and wore green yesterday. Today is Thank Someone Thursday. And so teachers, you're gonna be provided some paper and scholars, we would like for you to write some thank you notes to really show that you are reaching out to others and saying thank you. So thank someone Thursday.
Hey. I love that.
It's been a really fun week. Thank you, counselors, for all you've done for it. And then last but not least, before we kind of kick off the end of our show here, we have our Love to Math Bingo winners. Very, very exciting. We're going to pick two winners from kindergarten through second grade and two winners from third through fifth grade. So anybody who turned in their bingo sheet last Friday, I have an announcement for you. So first I'm going to do our kindergarten through second grade winner. All right, I'm gonna shuffle them up. Shuffle all those bingo cards. Our first winner is Harper in Miss Chapman's class. Congratulations, Harper, in Miss Chapman's class. So, Miss Chapman, you and Miss Paldino is going to bring that child his prize. So, you just wait patiently, Harper. All right, our second winner in K to two is shuffle it up. Lorelai in Miss Hurton's class. Lorelai and Miss Hurton's class. So Miss Hurton, we will be bringing your prize to Miss Lorelai. Congratulations for everyone who completed their bingo card in K to two. Now for our third through fifth grade winners. We have two winners here, and boy oh boy, did we have a lot of entries in third grade. So excuse my shuffling, I gotta shuffle these up. Third through fifth grade winners are Sydney. We're not sure which grade level, but if you're a Sydney and you turned on in your bingo card in third through fifth grade, teacher, email Miss Paladino if you have a Sydney in your class. Sydney. Congratulations, Sydney. All right, our next winner in third through fifth grade mix them up real good. We have Lila. Lila, I'm guessing I know which Lila, but Lila in third through fifth, if you have a Lila in your class, third through fifth grade teachers, email Miss Palladino so she can bring you your prize. That was Lila in Sydney. Congratulations, guys, and thank you to everybody who did your bingo card. That's very awesome. Fun, very fun. All right, well, the moment we've all been waiting for, a reason we have a special guest today. It is our final days of National Hispanic Heritage Month. And we have a special guest here to tell us what country we are doing today.
Awesome. I am so happy to be here and share about my heritage with you guys. So I am actually 100% Colombian. I am from Colombia, South America, which if you see Brazil is big and green, it's right to the left of Brazil. My mom and my dad were both born there and lived there until they grew up. My grandparents and my great-grandparents and my great-great-grandparents, everyone has been from Colombia. So I am actually a first-born U.S. citizen. So I, no one in my family before me, no cousins, no aunts and uncles, no parents had ever been born in the United States until me. So I feel kind of special because I was a trailblazer for my family, but it's also really cool to know that I have all of this heritage from Colombia. So I'm going to share a little bit about Colombia with you guys today.
Okay. Thanks, Ms. Restrepo. That's amazing. All right. Let me move on my face here to make sure I can see all the pictures. There we go.
Yeah, there we go. So you will recognize the flag as yellow, blue, and red. That is the Colombian flag. Colombia has more species of birds than all of Europe and North America combined, because Colombia actually has part of the Amazon rainforest in it, which is really cool. It is the world's leading producer of emeralds, which you can see in the top. They're like those green gems, and coffee, which I know a lot of your parents and your teachers drink coffee. Probably Colombian coffee. It is the second most has the second largest animal species of any country after Brazil. So most of the world's animals can be found there. It has a river known as Caño Cristales, or the Crystal River, because it changes colors. You might have seen pictures of it in different magazines or books, but it's beautiful. It's like a rainbow river. And one of my favorite things, Colombians make a hot chocolate called chocolate con queso. So my abuela, my grandmother, after dinner, before we would like sit down and read stories, she would make us hot chocolate and she would put a piece of cheese in the bottom. And I know that sounds weird, but the cheese would melt and it was like a little salty treat at the end of a sweet hot chocolate. So it was chocolate con queso. It's delicious.
Oh, I love it. That is so neat. I love that you had connections to all these fun facts, because you've visited this country many times and you've seen some of these things and you have experiences with your family with some of the facts. So that is amazing. Well, what else do you have?
Every year. So I wanted to share with you guys some pictures of my trips there. So like I said, I was born here, but both of my parents and all of their family members still live in Colombia. So we'd like to go back at least once a year to visit, because it gets kind of lonely being here on the holidays without having any family. So we fly back to Colombia. We have to take a plane on like a 6-hour plane ride to go see my abuela and all my tíos and tías and primas and primos, all my cousins, aunts and uncles. So I put some pictures of actually where they live. So in the top left-hand corner with the blue sky, that's actually my grandma's house. That's where we stay with my abuela. And in the town where my grandma lives, during Christmas time, they have this huge lights festival for Christmas, for Navidad. So it's called Festival de las Luces. It's the Festival of Lights. And they decorate all the streets with all of these Christmas lights. On the far right, where it looks like you can see all the way out, that's at the top of my grandma's house. If you hike really, really hard to the top of the mountain, that's the view where you can see close to the city. So where my grandmother is from and my family is from is called Medellin, Colombia. And that is the second largest city in Colombia. And it has a mixture of city and also mountains around it. It's called in a valley. So it's a city in the middle and mountains all around.
Wow.
And I, the my most favorite thing when I go to Colombia is eating guava, which in Spanish is guayaba. It's my favorite fruit, and we can never really find it here because we don't live in a tropical climate here in North Carolina. But guayaba grows in a tropical climate, and it is my favorite fruit. So my grandma knows every time we go to visit, she needs to be stocked up with guavas in the kitchen because she knows that all of us from the States are going to want to eat it because we never get to. So it is something very dear to me. And if you do have Hispanic heritage, I highly recommend asking your parents or asking your abuela or your abuelo or your tías and tíos to tell you about where you're from, to show you pictures, or when you go and travel, if you have the opportunity, take pictures, because these are memories that you want to pass down to generations after you, because you should be really proud of your Hispanic heritage. I know I am very proud of being Colombian.
Absolutely. Well, wow, Ms. Restrepo, these pictures are beautiful. I cannot believe this is your abuela's actual house. Oh, what a serene photo. I mean, that it looks like a painting.
And and it's called the Land of Eternal Spring, where my grandparents live, because it's just kind of like that spring 70 degree weather all year round. And it's wonderful. It doesn't get too hot and doesn't get too cold.
So beautiful. Well, thank you so much for being on the show today. That was incredible and a really great way to kind of close down our Hispanic Heritage Month, have someone with Hispanic heritage on the show.
Thanks for having me.
And we just hope you all have an incredible day of teaching and learning, and we will see you tomorrow on
Live with Lucky.